My name is Marcus Chu. I'm 16 and I'm really a techy person. I really enjoy building computers and searching up different computer stuff, I guess, playing video games also. At first it felt like I'm gonna be stuck here for like, I don't know how many months, but then after this whole printing happened and how it like kind of blew up in the media, it's like I've kind of been more productive than I ever was, ironically, since I'm quarantined, so. So this is how it looks like, or this is my design at least. And then these pegs over here are where the acetate holes are going to be punched. And because the acetate sheet is around A4 size, so my dad had a way to strategize it so that the punching is very, like, you don't need to always manually try and look where the punching hole is. You just fold the paper in half, then you fold it in half again, and then that's where you punch the holes. And then it fits perfectly in here. And then after you put this in here, it's pretty good to go. And then since these arms are flimsy, you need a rubber band for these hooks here to kind of seal it tight on your head. Yeah, it's pretty simple. If they're watching, I have nothing to say. I'm just like, because I look up to them like quite a lot, especially like people like Bill Gates, Elon Musk, those like giant tech people. It just makes me surprised, I guess, that yeah, and I really want to be like them. Like, I even have a book of Elon Musk here. For the people with 3D printers, you can honestly print a lot of things that could help the virus. There are people who have been printing like ventilations, masks, and then right now, for me, the frames. And for people who don't have access to that kind of technology, honestly, the one thing you can keep doing is just keep being happy, I guess. Make sure you're not succumbing to this pandemic, and make sure that you're still holding strong so that by the time that this is over, and it probably will be over, the world will just continue to be how it is, and maybe even better, because this pandemic is honestly bringing all of us together, and that's sort of good in a way.